In 1975, 5 miles from Auckland, in a little village which doesn't have anything instead of one harmless house and a plastic forming factory, a family of three persons moving. Their purpose is to get away from loud, busy big cities to a lonely, sunny and calm village. They were going by car on a dusty road. Garbage around the road looks nobody were around for a while. They seeing a house. Looks like that's the one that they bought. The whole house is dark. No color on the wall. From outside, it looks a medieval family house, which was built several ages ago. The car engines are turning off without its noise. The whole area is silent. No wind blowing on the steps you're making on the dust. The dad and mom getting out from the car, looking around, thinking that's the place what they were looking for. Their 8-year-old son is looking from the car's window, looking at the house. His eyes are saying, "Mom, Dad, please, I wanna go away. I'm scared." But he isn't talking too much. He's shy even to his own family. His parents saying, "Come son, see our new house." He's getting out from the car, scared, terrified. His legs were shaking. His mom asking, "Are you okay? What's wrong?" The boy just standing, looking to the dust. "Nothing, mom." His dad was already at the door of the house, looking into the window. The window is full of dust. You can see nothing in. He's trying to open the door, but it's obviously closed. The key has been left in the car. "Beauty, can you give me the key of the house from the car?" saying the dad. Mom with son holding hands and going closer to the car. The door. The car is closed too. She's trying to open it, hitting it, pulling out. Still closed. Her son saying, "Mom, mom." She looking to him and seeing he is standing and staring to somewhere. Asking, "What's wrong, honey?" He only saying, looking to the dust again. "Nothing," he said. She looking back to the car, and the door was wide open. The key to the door was at the seat. "There you are," she said. They both went to dad. She gave the key to him, pushing the key to the lock of the door, but it was already open. Smell of wind blow out from the house. Undescribable. Mixed with old furniture, rotten food, and wretched smell. But this noise damaging smell only realized by their son. His parents smelled nothing. The boy didn't want to go in, but his persistence was too weak to get back against his parents' speech either. They both went into the house. The first step in was a big happiness for our parents. And a big suffering for their child. Firstly, the living room, right side, the kitchen. In the living room, there was a couch, an armchair, moved like a circle. In the middle of the circle, there was a big lamp, but no cable from it. Next to the main door, there was the light button. Dad turned it on. The light got bright, but immediately blew up. Glass pieces were all around the floor. For one moment light, it got dark in a moment. "Great," Dad said. "Have you got some flashlight?" But in that moment, when he said, he found a light glass to replace the broken one. Broke the chair to reach the light. While mom and son were just watching how Dad fixing the electricity, their son seen something on the couch. It was fully dark. He seen some woman's shadow laying on the couch. The shadow didn't move. He just stared at the shadow and didn't move a little. Pulled his mom's jacket saying, "Mom, mom." She turned her head to the couch and seen something too. Turned her body and started to walk. Slowly to the couch, check what's that. Walking slowly, she holds still his son's hand. Almost reached the couch. Then Dad fixed the light. The dark vanished. So was the shadow. She was confused a little. Her son was so scared, almost his tears dripped out. Mom calmed him. Everything all right, son. It was nothing. There is nothing to be afraid of. Now they seen the whole room bright. It wasn't that horrible how it looked like from outside. It was already 7 p.m. They went up the stairs. The second level, there were 3 rooms, 2 bedrooms, and a bathroom. They packed up from the car to the house, to the bedroom. Their son has an own room, but he was so scared. Didn't want to sleep alone. His mom came closer to him and said, "There is nothing to be worried about," and gave him a kiss to his head and closed the bedroom door. "Sleep well, honey." He was alone in the bedroom, just standing in front of the door for some seconds, looking around. They ran to the bed, pulled the blanket to his head. It was fully silent, calm, and cold. The first night of the house. Haunted or perfection? We're gonna know at the second chapter of the story.